Good evening. On behalf of the school senior leadership team, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to Blairgowrie High School's annual prize giving ceremony. For those of you who don't know me, I am Leslie Hill, deputy head teacher and head of Glen Isla House. For those of you who have attended a prize giving previously, you will know that for a number of years it has been my pleasure to act as compere for this event. And I am still here, but looking out onto a very empty assembly hall. And it is sad that we are not able to welcome all prize winners and their families back into school for a second year. However, we have been resolute in our aim to recognise those who have made significant achievements, especially this year under such challenging circumstances. And so we have been recording each year group receiving their prizes, socially distanced, and now bring this event to you in a virtual reality. I am hoping that the IT team will make me look 6 inches taller and edit all my mistakes out. Traditionally, and as always, we begin with Mrs. Leslie and her head teacher's address for session 2021. Thank you. Thank you everyone for tuning in to the Blairgowrie High School 2021 Awards Evening. In 2020, I welcomed everyone to our Awards Evening from home as we were in lockdown. And I stated then that I hoped it was our first and last virtual Awards Evening. Whilst this year we are in school for our Awards Evening, the COVID restrictions again mean we cannot welcome parents, friends and sponsors to the school, but I hope you are enjoying our ceremony. As ever, I shall start with staffing news. During the course of the year, Mrs. Hayne, our guidance teacher for Tay House, retired. Mrs. Hayne has supported many of our pupils and indeed their families over many years. Mrs. Kate Hayne is currently enjoying more time in the garden, more time baking, and more time with her dog. But sadly, not a lot of the planned travel adventures yet. At the end of this session, Mr. Farrell in the Design and Technology Department retires. Mr. Farrell is looking forward to spending more time with his family, and he too has some travel plans. In the office team, Mrs. Scott is taking early retirement. In my time here, Mrs. Scott has exhibited a vast amount of knowledge about our families, always remains calm, and her experience and support will be missed. I wish to thank all of our retirees and wish them a long, healthy, and happy retirement. Mrs. Peacock in the Science Department welcomed a baby boy to the world, joining Mrs. Hendry and Mrs. McNiven, who were also on maternity leave. Whilst they have all enjoyed the joys that new babies bring, like many, they have missed out on the usual activities that would normally be part of baby life. All of our probationer teachers this year have secured permanent posts. Mr. Kirkwood, Maths, Mrs. Chamberlain, Home Economics, Mr. Mannion, Music, Mr. Henderson, Ms. Ed, and Miss Faulkner in English will remain as part of the Blairgowrie High School team, while Miss Johnston in Art is heading homewards to West Hill Academy. In Science, Miss Wilson moves to a school in Stirling, and Miss Keeper will stay with us for at least another session. Joining our team is Miss Beattie in the Home Economics Department, and probationers in English, Maths, Technical and PE. 2020, the year that no one will forget, said by myself at last year's award ceremony. Well, if 2020 was the year that no one would forget, 2021 must also be an annus horribilis, a terrible year. Schools work on a rhythm. Every year we prepare our young people not only for their examinations, but also for life beyond Blairgowrie High School. This year, that preparation and support for young people was made all the harder due to the uncertainties that we all faced, but without exception, all staff in Blairgowrie High School work their socks off to make the educational experience the best it could be for our young people under the circumstances. In second lockdown, teachers prepared their lessons for virtual delivery so that our young people had more structure and routine to their days. Mrs. Hill wrote 35 timetables. Writing one timetable is a mammoth task, but writing 35 variations as we try to be prepared for the First Minister's often awaited with apprehension Tuesday announcements was extremely challenging, but she did it. Of course, with no school bag mail, our office angels also had to find new ways to distribute information, but they did it. Mr. O'Hara's team was extended to ensure that calls were being made on a daily basis to families whose young people were not managing to engage with remote learning. Food parcels were delivered along with numerous devices. Whilst all of this was going on, school remained open for our intensive support provision pupils and for the children of key workers of our most vulnerable, and a special thanks has to go to our teaching staff, our pupil support assistants, librarians and our community link workers who, despite being understandably nervous, ensured that our in-school provision ran smoothly. Likewise, our Tayside contract staff for ensuring the building was extra clean and that we were all fed. Yes, our river was stolen from us this year and our journey has not been smooth sailing. I have been humbled by the efforts of all the BHS staff team to keep us going, whether from classrooms or dining room tables. But I now turn my attention to our young people. We know that they have shown our school value of perseverance in abundance this year. We know that everyone has tried their best. All BHS young people have adapted without complaint to our new school routines and safety measures. But we also know that this past year has taken its toll on many of our young people and their families. The well-being of our young people has suffered. We know this because they have told us, and many have reached out for additional support. As ever, we are here for our young people. In senior phase, the National Alternative Certification Model has undoubtedly added extra pressure to our young people. Exam results matter. They influence the next steps that young people take. Schools are often measured by exam results, perhaps because they are easy to measure. Not so easy to measure is the resilience shown by our young people, the kindness shown by our young people, the joy on their faces as they gain back social interactions that school affords them. Our exam results are good this year due to the effort of staff and learners. But I say to every single one of our young people, I am immensely proud of your conduct this year. 2020-21 will be a year you never forget, and it is easy to focus on the challenges of this past year, but please do not lose sight of your successes. You have shown perseverance in abundance, and as Babe Ruth once said, it's hard to beat a person who never gives up. Yes, our rhythm was stolen from us this year, but we found a new rhythm. Throughout, our parents, community, staff and pupils pulled together and we supported each other. As we move out of another year where COVID has robbed us of so much, as Susie Kasem, poet, writer and philosopher said, sometimes we have to soak ourselves in the tears and fears of the past to water our future gardens. So here's to our future, and I hope we all flourish in 2021-22 and beyond. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I would like to start by thanking Mrs. Leslie for the invitation to participate in this very special event in the school year with you all. It really is an honour to attend events such as this, and it's just such a shame that we all can't be together in the hall at Blairgowrie High School this year, not least because the prize-giving refreshments at Blair are second to none. In preparing for my short input, I have thought back to many such prize-giving speeches I have heard, both when I was a pupil myself, which indeed was the dark ages, predating the internet, mobile phones, Netflix, computers, and when the sun always shone in June, or at least that's how I remember it. And I thought about the people in my life who have given me some of the best advice I have ever had. And with your indulgence, I'm going to share some of that advice with you. Be ambitious. My favourite history teacher, Mr. Duncan, a person who really cared for and about his pupils, told me that it was all right to be ambitious. Ambition isn't a dirty word, he said. Channeled correctly, it can be the motivator to a satisfying life. Why should you not want to do well, to achieve, to be successful? However, the trait that pushes someone towards success can sometimes turn it into a game where winning isn't about achieving, it's about beating other people. So don't stray into that territory. Channel your ambition correctly. And channeled, ambition can bring great results. Challenge yourself. If something that you're doing doesn't challenge you, then it doesn't change you. We all have room for improvement in our studies, in our work, and as a person. You will rarely see any improvement in your life if you stick to your comfort zone. We often will only see what we're really capable of if we make the effort to exceed our preconceived limits. Don't limit the challenges you might encounter. Challenge your limits instead. If you think you can't, you're probably right. If you think you can, you're probably right. And I've my mum to thank for that particular piece of advice. Told to me often over many years, and much as it pains me to say so, she was right. Love what you do, so do what you love. This is my advice to you all, but particularly to those of you who will be leaving school and moving on to whatever lies ahead of you in life. I have always considered myself fortunate that from a very early age, I knew that I wanted to be a teacher. I also started practicing very early to be a teacher too, as many of my cousins will tell you. I used many of the times that we got together as an extended family to play schoolies. And I was, of course, always the teacher. And the work that was given was always real. And their patience often ran thin when I would make them reread a passage from a book many times over in the pursuit of fluency and expression. It is little wonder that some of my cousins are reluctant to sit next to me at family dues these days, just in case. Going to university for me was the means to be able to do the job that I desperately wanted to do. It wasn't a straightforward journey for me from school to university because of a number of reasons, not least that I undertook a caring role for my then much younger brother, and that meant that I could not take up the place I was offered at Edinburgh University the year I left school. Because of that, I stayed at home and went to university in my hometown a year later, thus enabling me to undertake the studies necessary to get the job I wanted, whilst also supporting my mum and younger brother. It wasn't easy, but then very often things worth having aren't easily got, and perseverance is the key. I stuck with it and graduated with an honours degree, and several weeks later got my first teaching job. And it really was worth it. At the end of my first month of working as a teacher, I couldn't believe that I also got paid to do the job that I dreamed of doing from a very early age. Don't get me wrong, the money was welcome and it was necessary. But I knew that I was fortunate to be in a job that I loved doing. And so began the career that has meandered this way and that and has brought me to being the Director of Education and Children's Services here in Perth and Kinross. I held on to my ambition, even when things were difficult, and I wore it lightly. I faced many challenges, but was not prepared to remain unchanged. I persevered when it would often have been easier to give up, and I'm still doing a job that I love. I wish you all well for your future. I hope you have a wonderful summer and that the sun might shine at least some of the time. And one last piece of advice in the form of a quote from Maya Angelou, an American poet. People won't remember what you said. People won't remember what you did. But people will always remember how you made them feel. So be ambitious. Challenge yourself. Persevere. Love what you do. And always leave people feeling better for having been with you. Thank you very much.
Our presentation of awards begins with pupils in the broad general education from first to third year. Starting with S1, our awards are for diligence, endeavour and performance. Katie Appleton. Ava Barton. Ellie Crichton. Cara Digwall. Stella Douglas. Sophie Hill. Oisín Marchbank. Maya Robertson. Gemma Smith.
Announcing the awards for second year pupils in the category of Diligence, Endeavour and Performance is Mr Sean O'Hara, Acting Deputy Head Teacher and Head of Tay House.
The following pupils in S2 have received awards for Diligence, Endeavour and Perseverance within the broad general education. Jacob Alexander. Bell. Andrew Craig. Callum Fife. Ramsay Gregor Jenny. Nico Greiger. Ilsa Kerr. Cody Warner. Eva Wilson.
So presenting the awards for our S3 is Mrs. Eleanor Rutherford, Acting Deputy Head Teacher and Head of Stormont House. Zoe Davidson, Hamish Dobb, Freya Donaldson,
You endure award. Erin Douglas. Alex Howitt. Caitlin McKinnon. Chloe McInerney. Amy McCulley. Imogen Pengilly. Nicole Rattray. Peter Rutherford. Ruby Simpson. Eve Speckman. Ruth Watson. And last but not least, Honor Wood. I think we need to give everybody a round of applause. The Nurse McDougall and Shaw Award goes to Emily Stewart, who cannot be with us this evening. The Miller Gerrard and Hodge Solicitors Law Prize goes to Holly Sloan. For culinary achievement, Karen's Kitchen Quake goes to Chloe Milton, who can't be with us this evening. The Bob Ellis Award for Working with Others goes to Ellie Johnston. The Blairgowrie Lyric Choir Award for Singing goes to Emily Nicholl. Trophy for Outstanding Achievement in Business Education goes to Lucy Saul, who cannot be with us this evening. The Heather Hall Head Memorial Quake goes to Sebi Riscanu, who's also not with us this evening. The G.A. Davidson Blair Engineering Quake for Technological Studies goes to Lewis McLaughlin, who's also not with us. The Peter Casey Joinery Trophy for Service and Example to the School goes to Tom Kelly. The Tilly Mutter Art Award goes to Shea Horner. The Perth and Kinross Council DYW Award for Employability Skills goes to Elena Tisepi, who's not with us this evening. And the Careers Management Skills Trophy, awarded by SDS Scotland, goes to Vanessa Bachokova. The WRI Shield for Hospitality goes to Claire Doig. Amida Trophy for Diligence and Perseverance in the Senior School goes to Peter Drummond. The Almeida Trophy for Diligence and Perseverance in the Junior School goes to Preston Duncan. Trophy for Citizenship goes to Cameron McMaster. The Climate Cafe Award for Environment and Sustainability goes to Honor Wood. Thank you. Orson and Black Cup and Perth and Kinross Council Medallion for Academic Excellence. This is known as the School Ducks Award. And I would ask that even if you're at home, please join us in being upstanding as we present our award to our School Ducks, marking an outstanding achievement in academic excellence, particularly given the difficult circumstances this year. Please stand. The Robertson and Black Cup and PKC Medallion for School Ducks this year goes to Tom Kelly.
Bring me fun, bring me sunshine.